Hello, my name is Mikhail Eremets. I work at Max Planck Institute for Chemistry in Mainz. During the fall of Berlin Wall, I was in Russia. I work in the lab as usual. In childhood, I did not have particular wish, I think. I interested in many things, very different. I would say mostly I played football. Gradually after that, I understood that science is good for me. I like it. We have two big goals for nearest future. First of all, to make metallic hydrogen. Second, to reach room temperature superconductivity. About metallic hydrogen. So long time ago, it was predicted that hydrogen can transform to metal at very high pressures. And in fact, this metal is very common because it's main constituent of Saturn and Jupiter. And because they are biggest in our solar system, so metallic hydrogen is the main material, most abundant materials in our solar system. It's more than enough reason to study it. But for us, more interesting are properties of hydrogen, because it was predicted that hydrogen might be room temperature superconductor. And what progress we have recently? So we achieved, in fact, metallic state in hydrogen. We showed that it transformed to so-called semi-metal, pure metal, at 3.6 megabar. It's very high pressure. It's pressure inside of our S, in the center of our S. So now our next goal, hopefully not very far away. Of course, it's very difficult. Next goal is to reach atomic hydrogen, because at higher pressures, molecular hydrogen, which we studied so far, should transform at 5 megabar to atomic state. And this atomic state, hydrogen atomic state, should be good metal and superconductor, according to predictions, high temperature superconductor. Second goal is to reach high temperature superconductivity. We studied hydrogen in some substitution form in alloys of hydrogen with metal and found so far that this metal can be superconductors with very high critical temperature, minus 23 degrees. So now our next goal, I very hope it's not far, really close. It's room temperature superconductivity. We need more, about 4 kelvins more to reach it, this point. And according to predictions, it's possible. How to generate pressures? We do it with such cells, so-called diamond anvil cells. This can be even much smaller. So essentially, it's a very simple device. It consists only from few parts. The most essential part, of course, diamonds. And you can see diamond on the top of some seed. Inside of cell, we have two diamonds and gasket in between. And we can put these parts together. And basically, cell is ready for operation. So we generate pressure very simple by rotating this with this key. We apply force and generate pressure. That's it. We studied high hydrogen, the simplest material, for a very long time. And recently we found some new results. First of all, we found that pure hydrogen transforms to metal at very high pressure, 3.6 megabar. This is pressure inside of our S. And second, we also studied materials which contain a lot of hydrogen, so some kind of substitution of pure hydrogen. And we found that these materials have very interesting properties. First of all, they transform to metal at much lower pressure than pure hydrogen. And second, the most important, these metals are superconductors, and superconductors with very high critical temperature. For instance, we found that compound of sulfur with hydrogen has is superconductor even at minus 70 degrees. Even more, lanthanum hydride is superconductor at minus 23 degrees. So it's nearly room temperature superconductivity. And this way shows clearly that room temperature superconductivity will be achieved most likely very soon. Even more, this way of searching for new superconductors also shows that very likely will be progress in ambient pressure superconductors with high temperature critical temperatures. About practical applications. Not now, because now we're working at very high pressures. Sample is very small, it's very difficult to manage these samples. But our studies show a new way how to find new superconductors. And if this way, at ambient pressure, and if this way will be successful, so new superconductors can change the world and maybe dramatically. Remaining questions? Yes, of course, a lot. We're only in the beginning, in fact. Even we had already a very long way behind, we're still in the beginning. So I hope in the observable future we will have atomic metallic hydrogen. I hope very soon we will have room temperature superconductivity, and also long way to ambient pressure superconductors with high superconducting temperature. One of the main problem currently is for us is pressure. So we desperately need very high pressure above 5 megabar. And now we are just at the edge. We sometimes reach 5 megabar, but we should have it regularly for reliable, good work and to reach atomic state of hydrogen reliably. First, they already know that when they see on sky and see Jupiter, now you can see it, by the way. So they know that Jupiter is full of metallic hydrogen. But also they know that it's very difficult to get it.